Welcome to Health Assist. Today we will learn about the physiology of skin, what it say in Yunani system of medicine and why it is made and what's the normal structure and functions of the skin. So to know about this, the physiology of the skin, let's begin with the name of Allah. Let's start with the name of Allah. Today we will learn about the physiology of skin. What is skin and what it say in Yunani system of medicine and why the skin is made and what's the normal structure and the functions of the skin. So what it say in Yunani system of medicine? The skin is called as jild in the Yunani system of medicine, and the word jild is an Arabic word which means the external covering or integument of an animal, or it is also called as the outer protective layer of the body of any animal. It means jild is also called as integument. So the synonym of the skin are jild and integument. And the disorders or diseases which occur over the skin are known as amraz-e-jild or skin disorders or skin diseases, and this is also called as dermatological disorder. And about 1 in every 3 of all patients and a general practitioner suffers from a skin disorder, and most dermatological diseases are chronic in nature and decrease the daily quality of life. And the skin diseases may affect the whole skin of the body, like Bursobahec, which is called leucoderma and pityriasis in modern science, and in case of Juzam, which is called as leprosy in modern science. While some skin diseases mainly affect a specific portion of the body, like Bulghora, which means alopecia areata in the modern science. Now it is considered that amraz-e-jild means skin diseases cause a huge burden in the global context of the health. And according to Global Burden of Disease study 2010, the skin disorder were the 4th leading cause of non-fatal burden due to disability in 2010. And thus it is considered that amraz-e-jild are one of the most common illnesses. It affects all the regions of the world. And the details of the skin and its appendages are necessary to understand the disorders related to it. Now, why skin is made? According to Ibn Rushd, also called as Averroes, he said the skin is made to cover and to protect the body, and the skin acts over the outer portion of the body same as the gisha or membrane acts over the internal organs of the body. Now, according to Ibn Sina, also called as Avicenna, Avicenna said that the agushia or membranes are made up of fine and invisible nerve fibers, and they provide sensitive covering to the insensitive internal organs of the body. So this is the same in case of skin. It means skin also provides the sensitive covering to the outer portions of the body. Now, according to Ibn Hubal Baghdadi, he said skin is an uzve basit, means simple organ amongst all the azay basita, and it is composed of muscles, tendons and nerve fibers through which touch and tactile sensations, that is hisse lumps, are perceived. And hisse lumps, that is touch and tactile sensation of the skin, is also proved by modern science. According to modern science, very fine nerve fibers have been identified in the epidermis, and there are several kinds of specialized sensory receptors found in the upper dermis that detect particular sensations. So, skin is the largest and most visible organ of the body, and that is also one that ages fastest. In an average adult, the weight of the skin is about 4 to 5 kilograms, which accounts about 7% of the total body weight. And along with its derivatives and accessory structures like sweat glands, sebaceous glands, hairs, nails, blood vessels or nerves, the skin becomes a part of the integumentary system. The word integument refers to a covering. And the skin is composed of mainly two kinds of layers. One is superficial epithelial layer, that is the outer layer, known as epidermis. And the another layer is an underlying connective tissue layer, that is the inner layer, known as dermis, also called as corium. Now let's start the epidermis. So epidermis is the outer layer of the skin. It is formed of non-vascular stratified epithelium. It means the epidermis does not have blood vessels, but the nutrition supplied to the epidermis by the small capillaries of the dermis. And its usual thickness is between 0.07 mm to 0.12 mm. It means the epidermis is not uniformly thick throughout the body. At some places it is thick and at some places it is thin. So it is very thick in certain parts like the soles of the feet and the palms of the hands, ranging from 0.8 mm to 1.4 mm thick. And it prevents most, but by no means all, substances from the entering the body from the outside. So the purpose of the epidermis is to produce semi-impermeable membrane known as the stratum corneum, also called as horny layer, that is the outer layer of the epidermis. You should know the layers of epidermis. Epidermis is formed by five kinds of layers. So the layers of the epidermis from the outer to the inner side are as follows. First one, the stratum corneum. It is the most outer layer of the epidermis. And then second one, stratum lucidum. And the third one, stratum granulosum. Stratum means layer. So the fourth one, stratum spinosum. And the last and the deepest layer of the epidermis is stratum germinativum. Now the first layer, that is the stratum corneum. This layer is the most superficial and its outer surface is exposed to the atmosphere. And it is also known as cornified layer or horny cell layer of the epidermis. And it is characterized by strength, flexibility, elasticity, toughness and dry surface. It consists of many layers of non-nucleated, flattened and cornified cells. And all the keratinocytes of this layer abruptly lose all of their organelles and nuclei. And this layer becomes thicker with the application of intermittent mechanical pressure. This layer is thickest on the palms of the hands and the soles of the feet, but the thinnest on the outer aspect of the lips, on the glans penis and over the eyes. And when the dryness of this layer becomes excessive, then it cracks and curls. And this layer prevents water loss. And when it is affected, or deranged as in case of eczema or psoriasis, the water loss is greatly increased. So that severe dehydration can occur if enough skin is affected. And this layer, stratum corneum, also acts as a barrier to the penetration of chemical agents with which the skin comes into contact. And it prevents systemic poisoning from skin contact, but the barrier properties are not perfect, as the occasional pathogen gains entry via hair follicle or small cracks and fissures and then causes infection. And thus, this layer provides a degree of mechanical protection against minor penetrative injury. And the remaining four layers will be discussed later. And to know more, just waiting for our upcoming videos on Health Assist. And don't forget to subscribe. Have a nice day.